Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I am going to be chatting with you guys about things that I am going to be doing differently with baby number two. I always want to give credit where it is due, and I actually got this video idea from Milena Cicciotti on YouTube. I was watching this video and I had these thoughts running through my mind already about things that I wanted to do differently during pregnancy and labor and postpartum and everything with this baby. And when I was watching her video, I just thought that it was a really great idea, and I wanted to share with you guys my thoughts and just things that I want to do differently. Also, if you hear something, Charlie is currently right at my feet. He stays directly underneath me all the time, and he is chewing on a toy. Basically, I just really feel like, especially for labor, I want to have a different experience. And I feel like a lot of moms feel this way. After their first baby, they just really realize what they want their birth experience to be like, since, you know, when you do it for the first time, you're really not knowing what to expect. And I just really wanted to share that with you guys. So I am currently 25 weeks pregnant, and my due date is September 6th. So I still have a little ways to go, but my mind is starting to go on all of the things that I want to pack and all the things that I want to do. And with my doctor, we've started talking about what a birth plan is going to look like and everything like that. So I want to start with a little bit of a backstory so this stuff kind of makes sense. So when I had River, I was 39 weeks and 4 days, and my water did not break and I did not go into labor naturally. I ended up having to be induced because I had toxemia and preeclampsia. Basically, when I was going to my doctor's appointments, they found a high amount of protein in my urine and my blood pressure was really high. I was feeling great. I had no idea that something was going on. I was obviously swollen just because I was 39 weeks pregnant, but I had to carry around a pee jug with me for a full day, and I had to take it to the hospital. And basically my levels were so high, they wanted to keep me for an induction. So when I was pregnant with River, an induction really wasn't my plan. I really wanted my water to break naturally and just have that whole experience, or to start having contractions. So because I was induced, they had to put me on Pitocin. And this is like the biggest thing that I regret, like with the labor from River, was that I got an epidural way too early. The reason that I got the epidural was because I almost felt like I was pressured into it, and I honestly wasn't advocating for myself and I didn't know much of anything. So when they started to induce me in that and they put me on Pitocin, I was about 4 centimeters, and it was the middle of the night, and the nurse came to check me, and they basically said, because I had been up for a long time already, things were moving pretty slow, that I should get the epidural now so that way I can sleep and rest throughout the whole night, and then in the morning we would have a baby. So in my head, I was just so nervous and so scared. I wasn't in pain yet, but obviously having a pain-free birth, I mean, duh. So I decided to get my epidural. And when I got my epidural, for the most part, everything was great. I had some issues with the IV in my arm, but that's a whole nother story. But everything was pretty good with my epidural until I was 9 centimeters and my epidural started to wear off. And I'm sure that the pain I was feeling was so bad and so intense, because I went from no pain to feeling all of the pressure and the contractions at 9 centimeters, and I was pretty much screaming. It was so incredibly painful, and they had to come in and mess with my epidural, and they were giving me more medication through the IV since I was in so much pain. So since the epidural wore off and I just felt like I didn't experience the birth that I wanted to experience with River, I really want to try to wait as long as I can for an epidural. Currently, my plan is to have a natural labor, but if I want an epidural, I'll get an epidural. Like, I'm not going to go into it saying that I'm not going to get an epidural just because I've never given birth naturally before and I'm nervous and I'm scared and I don't know if I'll be able to take the pain. I just want to wait as long as I can and just experience as much as possible of giving birth. I'm a weirdo. I'm into breastfeeding. I'm into natural products. I am into listening to birth podcasts and everything. And I just feel like birth, giving birth is such an incredible, amazing experience. And I know as a woman, like my body is made to do it. And I really just want to be able to experience that. But if the pain is too much, I will get an epidural. Like, I'm not gonna hold out on it. I know that it's an option for me, so I'm just gonna kind of play it by ear and see how I feel. But I am not getting an epidural at 3 centimeters. I am going to wait as long as I can. And my biggest thing is I'm just worried about it wearing off again. And that was like one of the questions that I asked the nurse when we were giving birth, and she said, like, your epidural can't wear off. And it did. So moving on from that. So the next thing that I really want to do, and I know that this is just a silly thing, but after I had River, I don't know why, but I had so much anxiety and I felt such an urge to like get up and start doing stuff. And I felt like I didn't give my body enough time to heal and rest. So therefore it took my recovery took longer. I don't know why, but when we got home, everything was done. Everything was clean. I mean, I had everything ready to go. I constantly felt like I had to like get water for people that were coming over to see the baby to constantly make sure that stuff is cleaned up. And I am not doing that this time. When we come home, I told Caleb we are going in our bedroom and we are posting up there for a couple of days, and I am not moving off of that bed other than to go to the bathroom. I really want to just take this time to just nurture my body, to just, you know, take those couple days just to stare at him and just be with him. And I just felt like I was rushing so much when I had River that it took me like almost 2 months to recover, and I had a lot of pain down there because I had stitches. And this time I just want to be more mindful. I literally just pushed a baby out of my body, and I just really want to take that time to rest and you know, just have that one-on-one time with my newborn. The next thing that I want to do differently, and I know that this is all like postpartum things, but there was like so much that I wanted to change, that there were just a couple things that I really wanted to do differently. And I know that everyone has a different opinion on this, but I produce milk. Like, mama can produce milk. And obviously when I had River, I didn't know any of that. And my milk came in when we were at the hospital, and my boobs were literally the size of cantaloupes. They hurt so bad. I couldn't touch my chest, anything. It hurt for my arms to be at my sides, and they told me not to pump. And I got home and I was reading all of this stuff online that women were saying don't pump because it would mess with your supply and all of that. I'm gonna pump. I'm gonna take my pump with me to the hospital. If my milk comes in and it's too painful, I'm gonna pump. When I get home, I'm gonna pump, and I'm not even gonna think anything of it. I was in such excruciating pain when my milk came in that I could barely even feed River. And when River would suck, the milk would just pour out of me on both sides. And I felt just so overwhelmed with how much I was producing. I know that everyone is different. Some women don't produce barely at all, and some women like completely overproduce, and I overproduce. So I just felt like, you know, I wasn't allowed to do that. I wasn't allowed to pump. It would mess everything up, and I'm just not doing that this time. It is not worth being in that much pain. And I just like, it's just like frustrating now looking back, because I was so worried about like what other like people's experiences were and what other people had said. And I was so nervous that if I pumped one time that it was going to ruin my supply. And I tell you what, the time that I pumped when we were home, it was the middle of the night and I couldn't take it anymore. I told Caleb to grab all my pump stuff and I sat there and pumped and the milk poured out of me. And honestly, it was such a huge relief emotionally and physically. I felt so much better and so much more comfortable. So I just want to say to you guys that if that's something that you're really nervous about, just do what you feel like you have to do. If you feel like you are very engorged in that and you need to relieve the pressure, just pump. Like, it's not that big of a deal. Your milk will end up regulating over the next few months as your baby feeds. And if it messes up your supply, just formula feed. Like, fed is best and it is not worth you being in pain. So for the newborn stage, I really don't have that much different that I want to do. It was more all like my birth and postpartum, but I just really want to take this time with our second baby just to stare at him and cuddle him and not feel like I have to clean the house or I have to get things done. I will be taking some sort of maternity leave on my YouTube channel, and I'm not sure exactly how that is going to work. If you guys watched my last Q&A with Caleb, we talked about filming the birth vlog. So I am planning on doing a birth vlog. I want to do a vlog at the hospital just so we have those memories, because that's something that I regret so much with River not having. But I'm not going to put pressure on having my 2 to 3 videos up a week. If you guys don't see me for 3 or 4 weeks, obviously you know what's happening, but I plan on filming an I'm in labor video beforehand and put that up so that way you guys know that the baby is coming and that I am in labor, and you guys can go ahead and head over to my Instagram when that video goes live, hopefully near September, and you guys can follow along on stories, because I won't be able to hold out. I'll be so excited to share him with you and just give you guys, you know, some real-time updates in the hospital. Another thing for postpartum that I just thought of that I really want to do that I didn't do with River was share my postpartum body. I felt like I had to hide myself, and I want to be so open and vulnerable with you guys and share with you what it is really like to have a baby. And I really wish that I would have done this with River, because so many women now, so much has changed since I've had him, and so many women now are, you know, sharing the real things. They're sharing what their tummy looks like right after birth and sharing what you use to go to the bathroom with. And I wish that I would have had that to look up to when I had River, because I would have went into the whole experience feeling less scared and knowing, you know, what was going to happen next and what my body was going to look like and how I was physically going to feel and everything like that. So I want to do like a full like birth Q&A, I guess. So if you guys have any specific questions for me, leave those down below and I'll get all the questions together and film a whole nother video. But I really just want to be as honest as I possibly can and just share all of the raw and real moments with you guys. So I'm just so excited and looking so forward to having this baby and having him join our family. And a lot of you guys are always curious, but no, this is not our last baby. I want lots of babies. I couldn't tell you how many we're gonna have, but definitely I want like 3 or 4 kids total. And I think basically what our plan is right now is we're gonna have our 2 boys and wait a couple years and have 1 or 2 more. So I've always really wanted a big family, and I'm just so excited about having 2 little boys. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video and you found some good insight on it and that you found it interesting. As always, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give this video a big thumbs up. So I love you guys. I hope that you're all staying safe and healthy, and I will see you in a couple days in a brand new video. Bye.